If you have a system A is equal to B, where A is in reduced row echelon form, then you should feel happy, because you can tell right away if the system has a solution or not. And in the case when there is a solution, you can tell whether it has a unique solution or multiple solutions. A few examples will make this clear. So first of all, some terminology. Suppose you have an augmented matrix given by this. The columns that contain the leading ones, in this case columns 1, 3, and 4, are called the pivot columns. And the variables that correspond to these columns are called pivot variables. And in this case, it will be x1, x3, and x4. The remaining variables are called free variables. In this case, there's only one, and there's x2. So how do we tell? By looking at the augmented matrix, whether a system has a solution or not. Consider this augmented matrix here. Now, look at the third row. We have zeros in the columns that correspond to the variables, and a non-zero on the right-hand side. This row represents the equation 0 equal to 1. Obviously, 0 cannot be equal to 1. No matter what values you set the variables to, this will never be satisfied. So this augmented matrix tells us that there's going to be no solution. Now, if the augmented matrix doesn't contain a row that is like this, then it will have a solution. Suppose that we are now looking at this augmented matrix. So this matrix does not contain a row where the entries in the columns corresponding to the variables are zero and the entry corresponding to the right-hand side is non-zero. Now, how do you get a solution out of this? The easiest way is to set the pivot variables to the right-hand side values. So the pivot variable in the first row is x1 and we set x1 to 5. And in the second row, the pivot variable is x3 when we set it to 4. And in the third row, the pivot variable is x4, we set it to 3. And the free variable, x2, we set it to 0. So this will give us a solution. So in general, you set the pivot variables to the right-hand side values, and all the free variables to 0, then you get a solution. Now notice that we can set x2 to any value. If we set it to a parameter s, we'll be able to express all possible solutions to the system represented by this augmented matrix. So we set x2 to s, and now the first row gives us x1 plus 2s equal to 5, the second row will give us x3 equal to 4, and the third row x4 equal to 3. And so expressing the solution as a tuple, we will have x1 is 5 minus 2s, x2 is s, x3 is 4, and x4 is 3. And so this gives us a solution for every value of s that we choose. So in general, if the augmented matrix tells you that there's going to be a solution and that there's a free variable, then you're going to have multiple solutions. But if there's no free variable, then you're going to have only a unique solution. So here's an example where that happens. Say my augmented matrix looks like this. Now notice that the third row is all zeros. This doesn't create any problem because this is 0 equal to 0, and it's not going to affect the choices that we make for x1 and x2. But here there's no free variable. Every column is a pivot column. So x1 has to be equal to 2, and x2 has to be equal to 3.